What's up? Welcome back to my channel. You guys, today I am so excited, and I feel like this has been requested. Not really, but I feel like it has, which I'll get into in a minute, but welcome back to my channel, guys. I have missed you. It hasn't been too long. I have put some videos up, but today's video, as you see in the title, I am doing another makeup video. The reason why I say this is sort of requested is because of the amount of views that I got on my formal night out makeup routine video. Go check that out if you haven't already. That was posted like a few months ago, and it has done very well. So I thought, I love doing makeup, and I've been actually planning a lot of makeup videos in my notebook right here, which right now I'm actually making a family tree. So comment down below if you want to see my whole family tree. I can talk about my whole family, how many families I have, all the ancestors, and all of that. So that's my family tree so far. Anyways, get rid of that stuff, because now we are bringing in makeup. Now today's video is going to be, I have actually gotten a bunch of new products that I'm going to try, and I'm going to just ones that are probably needed so that I don't use my mother's, or just ones that I wanted to try out that were cheaper. So that's sort of the video today, where I'm just going to be making a look out of the new products that I have. But I'm still using my old products, like my chocolate bar and, you know, can't have words today. What is this called? Remind me. Primer, there we go. That sort of thing. You know, my mascara, setting powder, all that jazz. But I have added a few new products into here, so that's exciting. And I will point you down so you can see sort of my area. Just a little bit, I guess. No, that's complicated here, guys. Let's see if we can get you set up. There we go. So then you can see my face if you want to see it. I mean, obviously I'm gonna be the foundation of this. Speaking of foundation, I do have my foundation right here, and I do have a nice lipstick that I'm gonna be putting on. I'm just showing you all the stuff that I'm gonna be using. Hold on. Is there anything in here? Not a fan. There's not really anything in there. But today, we'll start off with my primer, foundation, brows, eyeshadow, blush, beauty blender, my bronzer, blusher, and highlighter palette. So I've got bronzer and highlighter. There's blush that I'm not going to be using, but I will swatch it so you can see. And my lipstick, my setting powder, my mascara. On with the look. Alrighty, guys, so I will show you the new products that I have, which I bet you've already noticed. This Hide and Chic bronzer, blusher, and highlighter palette by Barry M. This was, I think, £2.50 that was at TK Maxx, which is basically TJ Maxx for America. But it's really nice. I will swatch it for you when I get to it. But those are the blushers, that's the bronzer, and then that's the highlighter. I actually got this from my mom, but you know, we always share. The one thing that I don't have today is a concealer, which I don't know where that's at. I have no clue, but you know, if you don't really need concealer, unless you have, if you're actually going out and you want to cover them, or you have any spots, so if you want to do that. The other new product that I have is this beauty blender, which I have actually, this is actually brand new, which right here, this was £2.20. It's a nice colored, because I always use my mom's, so I thought, I decided it's my turn to be like, let me buy my own. So, bought these two, and then, I think that's it. I'm pretty sure I bought her concealer too, which I don't know where she put that. I've been trying to find it, but I was like, whatever, my dudes. Whatever. But anyway, I'm just looking because it just looks less, just because I don't have like, oh, my contour, then my highlighter, then my just like a bunch of palettes. It's all in one, so that's nice. But yeah, I think that's all that's new. I think the rest you've already seen before. As you know from the other video that I did of makeup, that setting spray that I used, I was thinking it was this powder, but I actually found out in that video, we both all found out together, that it was the setting spray that was making the dots, and I think it was because I was doing it too close and I wasn't like, so, and plus that was a really bad squirter, so I'll have to try to figure something out for that. So I wasn't going to use it because I didn't want to ruin the makeup look, you know, obviously you don't want to ruin it. But before you even start doing your makeup, make sure you have washed your hands. I've done that. And you have wet your beauty blender just a little bit with hot water. Just a little bit, not too much. Rinse it out and left it for a few minutes. Which I just had dinner, so it's been left out for about 30 to 45 minutes. Almost an hour. So it's nice and still, like, damp. So it'll be nice when I'm applying the foundation on. So make sure you've done that, because that is a really good tip. So, you get, it's, words today are really hard. But, so that you get, like, a better put on of your foundation. That was horrible English, but you know what I mean, guys. You've worked with me before. So let's just get started. Anyways, we will start off obviously with our primer, which you can use moisturizer, which I do have moisturizer, which is my mom's, but this is my own primer. So I'm just gonna use primer today, like I normally do. But you don't have to do this, but this is just like a base for your foundation and everything that goes on top, just to protect your skin. And this is illuminating too. This is Hocus Focus Visual Floss Softening Illuminator Primer, so it's really nice and I like it because it gives me a little bit of a glow. And if you see me looking over here, I have a special mirror that I'm looking at so I can see myself and it's easier so I don't have to try to look at myself in the camera. So I'm just going to be applying this all over the face. Words are hard all the time when I'm on camera. I just can't say words, and it's just in general, I guess. Alright, so now that we've done that, can you apply like a good amount on? Bring it back up, put it back into its place. And this time I've actually set everything. But I think you can see more of a shine on me now. Once that's all in, then we will go into our foundation. So I was just getting these sleeves back. Make sure you do it on the back of your hand. Get a good blob. That's all I did. Make sure you have your correct skin color tone. If you don't have the brush, make sure you blend it all the way down here so no one can see the difference.
Then you're just gonna dab it in. First time using it, then make sure you just
gently dab all over the face
with it to get everything in. So I'll check back with you guys
when I've done the whole entire face and like a few sort of like a little bit went down the neck, just like that. So,
guys, another tip that I would do
before doing your makeup is make
sure you have your hair up, or I have like a little headband if my hair is down, or if it's like there's a lot of flyaways and it'll get away. Make sure you have like a little headband or bobby pins or something just to put your hair back. I got this for Christmas last year.
So, yeah. And also,
I'll talk about like just a little talk with you guys too.
My birthday is coming up, and I just wanted
to say what I was thinking to get for my birthday. Obviously, I think a lot of you know that I want to be a professional photographer when I grow up. So, that's what
I'm going for. So,
I would love like a nice camera. And for vlogging, so I'll get a nice vlogging
camera, which
can also take pictures, so I'll be like a 2-in-1.
So
I'm gonna get that going, or we could just have a nice
vlogging camera, because I would love that too. And that's definitely what I'm going to ask for my birthday and Christmas. If I don't get it for my birthday, I'll ask it for Christmas. That'll probably be for Christmas, because it's more of a bigger thing, and yeah, but testing out with makeup. Then my other thing would
just be if I could go on to Wish and have
like a whole little shopping spree on Wish. I'm gonna get a bunch of Wish products,
and yeah, I'm just gonna get like a whole bunch of Wish
products and
go crazy.
And test them out for you guys.
So I hope you guys will like that, because I am planning on that. I've already put a bunch of stuff on my basket, which I'm going to be doing
a video showing you,
like my what's on my Amazon basket, what's on my Wish basket. So
that's exciting, because then you'll see what I'm up to and things that I'm going to be doing for future videos. So little sneak peeks.
So I think I've done it all. I've applied all the foundation. Can't really see it. It's because it's a nice, then we are going to go on to
these next. So you can look, it's Archery DIY Brow
Bar, which I will show you. It's a form and shaping, perfecting, highlighting, and painting kit
for your brows. So this is really good because it shows you what to do, and I'll show you what to do.
If you have this, so you have two brushes, which the other one, my mom dropped
this one day, and
the other brush,
we couldn't find it because it's so small, like it's one of these,
but it just has like one end, so then you can
dip into whatever. And basically she
was,
you know, trying to put it on, then she accidentally dropped it,
and
she couldn't find the other brush, like we didn't
know, it just like disappeared, so we looked
all over the bathroom, wasn't in there. So
we'll eventually find it, and so first of all, what you're going to do is you're going to take this end, which looks like a mascara brush, and you're going to brush down your eyebrows, whatever you want to do. If you want to go like up at the start, and then go like that, or if you go up all the way,
I go up
at the front, whatever you want to
call that, and then go down over here. Look at a full close up
at the end. Then you'll take the other side and you'll dip into one of these shades. And this is just to start it, it's not the actual color. It softens the brows and gets ready to go
on. Feels like a gel.
Doesn't really show, you just blend it into the
brow like I'm doing.
again. But now I'm just gonna dip straight into the color. So if you have like sort of greenish brows, you would go for that. Like if it's like a green brownish color, you'd go for that. Or if you have just like brown, darker, you'd go for that one. So I'm gonna go for that one. As much time as you can, and then go in.
And just
fold them in. If you need to overline them.
And whatever you do with your brows, you can. I just
like to fold them in. So it's like formal or something. Or if I'm just testing out
different things. As you can see, it's a big difference from the other one, because this is just filled in. So then we'll do the
next one. It looks weird at first because I don't know what to put the face on. Don't worry, I'm getting there. And if you overline or something that you don't want to do if you mess up, either get like a wipe, or it's easier to just
cover it up with concealer if you do have concealer. It's way easier to do that. If not, just use a wipe. If not, worst case, just use your foundation again.
Okay. Those are done now and all filled in, so we're just gonna put that away. And the next thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do my eyelids. So we'll do some
eyeshadow and we'll do just a
real cute look.
What am I thinking today? I will tell you what I'm gonna dip into.
So, as you can see, there's a lot in here. I'll go for one more piece, Think Friday, which is Friday today. Yes. And I'll go for more. Yeah, so we'll go one more piece, Pleasure Girl, Think Friday, and more. So I'll show you what those dupes are. And we'll also go for You Need Love. So, and Endorphins Ready. So we'll go for Endorphins Ready, You Need
Love.
Which one's Pleasure Girl? Pleasure Girl. Think Friday, Pleasure Girl, what was that one? That was One More Pieces, and More. So those are what we're going to go for today. You'll see, and I'll just call them out as I go. Right there, you can look at the palette good. That one, that one, that one, that one, and that one. And you can also dip into any of the other ones that you want.
So I'm just gonna
take one of my eyeshadow brushes, which I'll go for
this one.
So nice eyeshadow brush.
And I'll dip into
the shade, we'll start obviously going underneath the brow, highlighting it. So we'll do the one that is You Need
Love, which is this one. And do right at the bottom of
the brow. I always start from the top and go to the bottom. That is a good tip. And also, if you're looking like a little bit blotchy and
if you need to be blended, just grab a big brush or a
blending brush and just blend it up so it looks even. Sometimes that's what you need to do.
Alright, so now that we've done that, it doesn't really
make a difference, but it will later on. We are going to dip into,
so we always go,
yeah, so we'll go right here. Oh no, we'll go with One More Piece, that one right there,
at?
At right under where you
just did.
Right under
the one that you just did, under the brow. So the one
that you just highlighted, sort of the brow, and then right under there, above the crease line. Is what I should say, like the
booty groom.
That's what it looks like so far.
This?
Sort of. I'll get you
into
light.
In a minute. It's a little bit dark outside,
or else you would have seen it better, but. Looks good up close. Okay. Then we're gonna go for a darker one, which.
Pleasure girl.
It is. Oh yeah. Yeah, so we're gonna go and dip into Pleasure Girl, which is the darker shade. This is the darkest one we're gonna use. Which is gonna go right on the outer, which I'll show you. Basically just gonna go
right
out there, like if you were
going to do so just at the
end of the crease. It's like not all the way in, you're just going halfway and going right above the
lash. Right on the in the crease. And then if you want to, you can go out and sort of
blend it out more. Just really dip into that shade and make it look really nice together. We're going to dip in
True.
This one, which is the lightest one we're going to do, which is Thank Friday, which is Friday, so that's part of the reason why I'm going with this look, because of that. One day I'll do a look like it's all pink or really vibrant colors, is what I'm going to do.
Next! Today, I'm
just doing
nice look today. Then you're just gonna grab it and you're gonna go right
in the crease and out. Now that we've done that, we're gonna grab a little
bit more of You
Need Love. I'm getting to know these names now. And we're
going to go right up below that
lash, that brow line, just because if there's any of the other eyeshadows that have gotten there, you need to make sure that you have covered it back up with your love shade or your white shade, whatever you've brought, if you have a different palette than me. There we go, that's better. Then we're going to go dip into Endorphins Ready, and we're going to put it right in the line crease, whatever you want to call it,
right there. So let's dip into that. This is a really pigmented one that is,
so it's like the white one, but it's got like glittery shine in it. So we're going to
put that right into that.
Then it makes it shine. And then you can go in with the other one and do it again with the You Need Love one, because it really makes it pop out when you do it. And then you can grab another more of the Endorphins Ready, the shiny one, and you can go up here underneath the brow line and make it just like halfway, and it really makes it shine up and pop. So now when I'm doing that, you can see it pop
right under the brow,
which you will be able to see when I show you in light. It looks really good right here. I can't wait for you guys to see this. Looks great. the next thing I'm going to be doing is doing the other eye. So that's all basically I'm going to do for that eye. So I'll let you have a really good close-up right now. Which I will move the camera this way.
And you'll be able to see.
As you can see, I've sort of done like a pull out right here, and then the white up here, then the shiny, you can see the shiny that I did right here, and then with the black, it looks like a little bit of purple in the thing, which you can add purple if you want, and then we have the lighter one right into there, the dark one on the outer edge, and then we have our little milky chocolate one in them right there. So here's that again, and then I'm gonna do the other eye off camera and then get back to you guys when I'm done. So
yes,
alrighty guys, so I'm excited because I have done these. As you can see, you can already see
a little bit, but I'm
going to show you a little bit of a close-up again.
So I've done both eyes,
this one off camera, this one on camera.
You can see, I did some little touch-ups.
It looks really, I think it looks really nice with the little highlight in the inner. It defines the nose more, and it makes them pop. And then it really makes the green and the, hazel pop out of my eyes, because normally people think my eyes are brown when they're actually like green and hazel, as you can see. So it's really creepy, but they are actually green and hazel mixed. So you can
really see that when
this is on. So I hope you guys like this. And
you can turn this way too.
Let's see how it looks.
So as you can see, it's looking fabulous right now. But anyways, we are going to move on to the
next thing on the list. And then you guys are going to fall off your tripod.
Let's
position you correctly. That is not
crooked.
Alright, so now that I've done that, we're going to do blush. I know I have blush in my 3-pack, but, it's more of a brighter blush when I want to go for more of a subtle blush. It still is a good blush, but I personally think this one is better. So I'm going to go for my usual. I'm going to take my blush brushes and my blush brush. And
we're going to dip into that shade and that shade like I normally do.
And sometimes, since I'm going for like a lot of shiny, I'm going to go for that too.
Once I've mixed them.
Make sure you don't put too much on the brush. And, frankly, I like to go a lot right here. Not like, too much, but you know. Go right there. Now we've got our blush on. And we've got it all blended out correctly. I'm going to take just
a little bit of the shiny stuff
and go. If you've got too much, just make sure you blend it in well. And if it's way too much, then just take a wipe.
Wipe it off. And then do it on the other side.
On both sides now. Nice, and then we're gonna go into
the contour.
Well, the bronzer, I should say. I'll swatch these
right now. So I'll swatch the guys, so you can see this. So, oh,
here we go. So there's the bronzer. And then we'll take the blush. You can see that. This is the really
pinky one.
It's not very pigmented, which is good in a way. It's not the best blush in the world, but it's okay. I will still wear this. I would wear this if I needed to, so I keep forgetting. There's the pink. And then I'll show you the highlighter. Can't really see it too well, so I'll really show you because it's actually, you guys can probably see it. Yeah, you can see it right there at the bottom if you have good eyesight. It's just a little bit shiny, and then there's another blush, apparently. I'm gonna try this. So this is like a, you can see at the bottom there. So that's pretty good. Okay.
I'll put you guys back into place.
Yeah, so those are pretty good. So we're just gonna go in with the bronzer now. Take my bronzer brush and really pack it in there. And then you're gonna go, see, I figured this out. I think going from the bottom of the blush is easier. So that's what I've been doing recently, and it's looking way better when it's at the bottom and at the top of the blush, because it looks like my cheekbones are way higher than they are. So I'm defining it more at the bottom, which looks way better to me. So I hope that's looking better as an improvement from last time.
I
think it is. And then
this actually is a
really good bronzer. I give this a strong 7.5 out of 10. This is a
good,
it really packs on there. Like, as of my other one, you have to really get on the brush to make it
good and pigmented. Go at the bottom of the cheek,
define those
jaw lines.
You can go for your collarbone if it's showing. You can do whatever you want.
Then you can go on
to the nose bridge.
Which mine's doing pretty good because of the highlighter, how it's
defining that. So I'm gonna leave that. Then I'm gonna go at the very top of my head. Still do that. Okay, done that. Then we will move on to highlighter, which I still do it the same at the top of the blush. My highlighter brush. And really get it on there. Then it doesn't shine the greatest, but it does still do the job, so I'm not
really complaining that too much.
And then I do the second one that they have like a different one, so try that out too. So I've done that now, and then we will do, I just want to make sure that I haven't put on anything. Then we'll do some setting
powder. So we'll grab my
powder brush. I have a powder brush right here, which looks like my blush brush. It's really hard to tell, but I tell because of how this is more like stood up and more poofier, just because of the fact that it's a powder brush, and you get to pack it on there really well. And then my setting powder, I just do it all over my face. Some people do it differently. A lot of people bake, which I'm gonna get baking powder soon so that I can show you how to do that. And then I'm gonna start doing like separate tutorials on how to do certain eye makeup looks, how to do
brows.
Just focusing on different, just on a specific part of your face. So that's what I'll be doing soon too. If you want to see that, please comment below. I don't know if you want to see that. If you do, I would love to hear, because I want to do what you guys want to do. So If I'm going for a formal night out, I will put on real mascara, but this is better because sometimes I make mistakes, everyone makes mistakes, and it's hard for the mascara if I accidentally put too much on, and then when I blink it gets all the black mascara gets on your perfectly done
good
eye makeup that you just did. So I like to use this because it boosts your eyelashes, they look really nice and they make your eyes pop so good. But this is great, but it's not black, so it doesn't get everywhere if you blink or whatever. You have to be careful for the first 5 to 10 minutes so you don't get it on anything, and it doesn't like crust up and fall down, you know, at the bottom as you see.
So that's what I love
about clear mascara, even though it doesn't like make your eyelashes really black, like people like that, but
I just like using clear mascara, and it just really boosts it up.
So that's why I love using it, because I make mistakes a lot and like to put either too much on by accident, or I just accidentally draw the line, which I'm really good about not getting the thing in the eye, so that's what I'm really good about. Just if you get really put too much, and if I blink, it gets all over the place. Because if I blink, right, see what I just did right there? If that was not black mascara, regular mascara, it would go all, there would be little crusties, and it would just ruin your eye makeup.
So that's why
most of the time I don't do it, but if I really want to, or if I really should. It still looks really good without the regular, because it still gives you that boost, because a lot of people just use mascara for the boost.
So that's why I recommend this.
Yeah. So yeah, it looks really good now. It's nice, gives it a little
bit of a boost. Then, I think this is the last, but certainly not least, you can choose any lipstick. I'm just going to go for more of a
nice one, which I'll give you a little bit of a
swatch of it.
It's a really nice shade. I love this. So. Sorry if I'm quiet. I'm focusing. So I don't get it in there. I wish I was going out so much that I could wear this. I'll wear it for a little bit and then take it off before I go to bed. And I'm not wasting
it, but.
Because plus I'm going to be calling people from
America. So.
Look nice. And then if you have any extras, it's easier
for you to get the extras off.
And then if you don't want to like get it on your teeth or anything, just take a napkin, go. And then the excess will come off. So I'll go do that right now. I'll go grab a napkin and show you how to do that. You can go to it or whatever. Alrighty guys, so I've gotten some tissue, just wrapped it up.
And now, what you're going to do is you're going to go, it looks
weird, but squish it down. And then, as you can see, stuff off, the excess, the other hand, comb, whatever, fix it, and then you can do it again. That one got a good one. And then that means your FRS looks good. Perfect. There we go. And then you can do it for a final
time.
You can do that about 3 or 4 times if you want, whatever you prefer. Yeah, that's basically my makeup look using some new
products that I got.
My my new beauty blender, which was really good. Obviously, it's a beauty blender. It's nice. Good to use. And this, I'm really impressed with.
Although the blusher isn't that good, the bronzer is amazing.
It's really good pigmented.
Remember I said I would give it a strong 7.5 out of 10. And the highlighter, I would give it about
5. It wasn't the best, but it still does the job and it still glows a little bit. So I'm fine with it, and it's just highlighter. And if you, I would really actually go for using as a highlighter. If you have a
really nice in your palette,
in your eyeshadow palette, if you have a really nice shiny white,
you could use that because that would be way shinier.
If I show you guys, so this is the normal highlighter that it, okay, the light is, yeah, that's the normal highlight. That's not, that's more shiny because of this light. Yeah, if you look right here, it's a little bit shiny, not too much. If I add, using this color right here, Endorphins Ready. If I add it right here, look how much shine I will have. Oh, I need to put you guys in light so you can see. So there's that side. Here's this side. There's a lot, it's hard to see, but there is a lot more shine than because of just how shiny that is. So you could use, if you have a really nice one like mine, you could use that instead of good finding a highlighter. There's really good highlighters out there, but you know, this is just in the pack and it was really nice, and it still does the job if you want it. So yeah, I would give this whole palette a good 7, 6, 7. It's a really good palette, and it's good for the price. So that's what I say. And Barium does a good job. So, yeah. Yeah, so thank you guys so much for watching this video.
If you did,
please give me a big please give a big smash. Whoa. I cannot say words. Recently. if you like this video, please give it a big thumbs up.
Right now, I'm going
to show you the whole look.
So you're going to see that before I end the whole thing. So.
Guys, thank you so much for watching again. Remember to give a big like if you liked it, and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Join the family, our 20 subscribers in. I am sorry, I think that video will be before this.
Not sure, but
the desk tour, I'm very sorry. I was supposed to post it Sunday, but our internet has been really weird. It wouldn't let me post it. I don't know why, so I'm trying to get it up, and I'm really sorry. So most likely it'll be up tomorrow or tonight. Don't worry, it'll be up, and I'm very sorry for that. I promise it'll be up, and it's gonna be really good. I have already recorded it, I've already edited it, it's ready to upload, and I can't wait for you guys to see it because I've worked so hard on it, and it's probably gonna be before this video, and if not after. Sorry, it's probably going to be after this video, if not before. It's amazing. Please go check it out if it's already out. It is absolutely incredible, and I hope you guys enjoyed it because I worked so hard on it and have really put all my efforts into making it a really good video for you guys. So please make sure you check that out and be ready for it because it's going to be epic. Anyways, as I said, thank you guys so much for watching. Remember to subscribe, hit the notification bell, and hit all when you are hitting the notification bell. So then you get notified every time I post a brand new video. And I'm very sorry if the audio is going like on and off. I'm very sorry.
My iPhone does that for some reason. I don't know why. Comment down below if you know why the iPhone 6S does that. I need to check that out because I'm very sorry. It's probably annoying, but you know, you get over it and you can still hear my voice. And I'm starting to speak a little bit louder for you guys so then you can hear better. The swatches. Oh, yeah. Yeah, and if you like this makeup look and if you want me to do more, please comment down below too because I would love to hear. And I love doing these makeup videos and I love showing you guys what I have in my little inner talent. All my family members and my friends say that I do a really good job. So I really hope you guys enjoyed it because I love doing it and I love just showing my little inner talent that I never knew I had in me and showing you the little creations that you can make with a few products. And they're cheap on a budget. So, yeah. And thank you so much again. As long as I say that about like 20 times a lot. But, you know, thank you guys so much for watching. And yeah.